I think a very important question is the empowerment of women, in particular in areas of conflict. There's so much we can do just by being aware of the issues, by prioritizing them, the way in which we structure a mission. How does the leadership team look like? Do you decide to engage, to involve a gender advisor in the leadership team, or is it someone who's stuck somewhere in an office that nobody actually knows what they're doing, or they have three other tasks attached to it? I think we can do so much by actually doing so little. We're just changing little, and we can make a huge difference. And I think it's extremely important because we need to be, as international peacekeepers, we need to be role models for the societies in which we work. If we tell them you have to take care of your women, but then we ourselves conduct ourselves in a way that is not reflecting this view that I think many of our countries would like us to see ourselves. And of course, this focus on implementing the Security Council Resolution 1325 and also to empower women, of course, has come to the forefront immensely with the development in the Middle East and ISIS and the way in which is just horrific, the way in which women are treated there at the moment as we sit here and speak now. So I think that the effort we can do we're in a, I think, good situation, that the focus is on gender. We have achieved much, but of course, there's so much left to be done. It becomes so evident that this is an issue that we can address fairly easily if we decide to do so. And I think it's all our responsibilities and also the fairness to focus on this issue. In terms of what women can bring to senior leadership positions, they can bring many of the same things that the men can, and vice versa. And I think this is sometimes the problem, is that we don't see them the same, so we don't expect the same. But in many ways, it is the same. And I think we need to be better at finding, making use of the whole population, not just 50% of the population, when you're trying to find the right leader. Women can bring in, for instance, listening. Many men are great listeners too, but this is something that sometimes has been argued, that women can possibly be more in a conversational sort of mode. There's not too many women that have been in a position of command. You can still be a leader, but more in terms of in a coordinating function. I also think women in many cases have different experiences, and again, they are not better or worse, they're just complementary. It's good to have different competences in the team.